Welcome back. Today's topic is Sir Roger and Will Wimble. It is a great essay which was written by Joseph Edison. We'll go from the test. Wednesday, July 4, 1711. Here they have written a line. It was a line written in the language of, that is the Latin language. The meaning of that particular line is out of breath, to no purpose, and very busy about nothing. Okay. As I was yesterday morning walking with Sir Roger before his house, a country fellow brought him a huge fish, which he told me him Mr. William Wimble had caught that very morning, and that he presented it with his service to him and intended to come and dine with him. At the same time, he delivered a letter which my friend read to me as soon as the messenger left him. Okay, see here, it is the yesterday morning, that is yesterday morning, Sir Roger walking with our spectator. When he walked, during that time, one fellow came and gave him a huge fish, as well as told him that it was from Mr. Wimble, and gave one letter. In that letter, Sir Roger, I desire you to accept of a jack, which is the best I have caught this season. I intended to come and stay with you a week and see how the perch bite in the Black River. I observed with some concern the last time I saw you upon the bowling green that your whip wanted a lash to it. I will bring half a dozen with me that I twisted last week, which I hope will serve you all the time you are in the country. I have not been out of the saddle for 6 days last past, having been at Eton with Sir John's eldest son. He takes to his learning hugely. I am, sir, your humble servant, Will Wimble. So this is the letter. In this letter, he expressed that his feeling upon Sir Roger. Will Wimble, that he, how he spent his last 6 days, and then what fish he catched. Jack is also a type of fish, and perch is a type of a fish. And then it is used for the bite in the Black River. In the Black River, they all go for a fishing. During the time of fishing, they used to give some little food to the fish to catch it. So that is called a bait, and perch is also a type of fish. Okay. After reading the letter, so this extraordinary letter and message that accompanied it made me very curious to know the character and quality of the gentleman who sent them, which I found to be as follows. Will Wimble is younger brother to a baronet and descended of the ancient family of the Wimbles. He is now between 40 and 50. Okay, after reading the letter, Sir Roger and the spectator was very curious to know about that person. That person is a very younger brother to a baronet, and then he is in the family of Wimbles, and now he may be a 40 and 50. The age may be a 40 and 50. But being bred to know business and born to know estate, he generally lives with his elder brother, a superintendent of his game. He hunts a pack of dogs better than any man in the country and is very famous for findings out of hair. He is extremely well versed in all the little handicraft of an ideal man. He makes a mayfly to a miracle and furnishes the whole country with angle rods. So see here, this person, that is a Wimble, is a person who is a younger brother. He works under his own elder brother to superintend of his game, because he is not going for any job. He need to take care of his brother's business, but he is very much interested in hunting, as well as a very good at hunting and in making the tools. And he is well versed in the handicrafts. He makes a mayfly a miracle and furnishes the whole country with angle rods. As he is a good-natured, officious fellow and very much esteemed upon account of his family, he is a welcome guest at every house and keeps up a good correspondence among all the gentlemen about him. He carries a tulip root in his pocket from one to another, or exchanges a puppy between a couple of friends that live perhaps in the opposite sides of the country. Will is a particular favorite of all the young hires, whom he frequently obliges with a net that he has weaved, or is setting a dog that he has made himself. He now and then presents a pair of garters of his own knitting to their mother or sisters, and raises a great deal of mirth among them by inquiring as often as he meets them how they were. This gentleman, like manufacturers and obliging little humors, make Will the darling of the country. Here in this paragraph, we can see that how he becomes a very darling of to the particular people, because William character is that he is a very very much care about all the persons, because his main occupation is hunting, but he is actually a very ideal person and wastes his time with making trifles for the women folk. He often makes net and presents them to his friends. Sometimes he obliges the ladies with the garters of his own knitting. So these are all the favorite thing. With this favorite only, he becomes very very close to the person. When he goes and meet the person, he used to carry the tulip root, as well as he exchanged a puppy. So many things with this, because he is very very simple and human in nature. Okay, next. Sir Roger was proceeding in the character of him, where he saw him make up to us with the two or three hazel twigs in his hand that he had cut in Sir Roger's wood as he come through them. On this way to the house, I was very much pleased to observe on one side the hearty and sincere welcome with which Sir Roger received him, and on the other the secret joy which his guest discovered at sight of the good old knight. After the first salutes were over, Will desired Sir Roger to lend him one of his servants to carry a set of shuttlecocks he had with him in a little box to a lady that lived about a mile off, to whom it seems he had promised such a present for above this half year. Sir Roger's back was no sooner turned, but honest Will begin to tell me of a large cock peasant that he had sprung in one of the neighboring woods, with two or three other adventures of the same nature. Odd and uncommon character are the game that I look for and most delight in, for which reason I was as much pleased with the novelty of the person that talked to me as he could be for his life with the springing of a peasant, and therefore listened to him with more than ordinary attention. Okay, see here, this description is a gives. Sir Roger was interrupted by the arrival of Mr. Wimble himself. The spectator noticed how sincerely the old knight welcomed the gentleman, and how Wimble, on the other hand, was also happy to meet Sir Roger. Now, Will Wimble is entering to the house of Sir Roger. Will Wimble desired the knight to lend him one of his servants to carry a box of shuttlecock to a lady whom he had promised the present for more than half a year. Will soon inform the spectator of this recent adventuring in hunting, and they appeal to the spectator. Now, okay, next. In the midst of this discourse, the bell rang to dinner, where the gentleman I have been speaking of had the pleasure of seeing the huge jack he had caught served up for the first dish in the most sumptuous manner. Upon our sitting down to it, he gave us a long account how he had hooked it, played with it, foiled it, and at length he drew it upon the bank, with several other particulars that lasted all the first course. A dish of wild fowl that came afterwards furnished conversation for the rest of the dinner, which concluded with the late invention of Wells for improving the quail pipe. So here, during after the bell rings, the dinner has started. While the dinner started, here with this two, with the two thing only, the conversation were occurred with the Jack, which was caught by Mr. Wimble morning, and then on the dish of wild fowl. So about this two only they were speaking. And then Will Wimble explaining the adventure, what are the things he faced in last few days. Here we saw that wild fowl also furnished with all interesting subject for conversation for the rest of the dinner. Okay, next, after the dinner, upon withdrawing into my room after dinner, I was secretly touched with compassion towards the honest gentleman that had dined with us, and could not but consider with a great deal of concern how so good a heart and so such busy hands were wholly employed in trifles, that so much humanity should be so little beneficial to others, and so much industry so little advantageous to himself. The same temper of mind and application to affairs might have recommended him to the public esteem, and have raised his fortune in another station of life. What good to this country or himself might not a trader or a merchant have done with such useful through ordinary qualification? So here, after dinner, when the spectator went to his room, he was thinking about the character of Wimble. He felt very pity for his gentleman, because he felt that his good heart and busy hands are wasting on this petty job, because he would need to take care of his brother's job. If he had attempted any occupation, he could have raised his fortune in care to go in another station of life. His services then would have been more beneficial. They would not care to go in for a common profession which is beneath the quality. This often ruins a great families. In England, usually the younger sons may choose any other profession. As a result of this, people who have started with much means have been found to have risen to a greater estates than those of their elder brother. Yes, because see, in the next paragraph we can see that Will Wimble is the case of many a younger brother of a great family who had rather see their children starve like gentlemen than try in a trade or a profession that is beneath their quality. This humor fills several parts of Europe with pride and beggary. It is the happiness of a trading nation like ours that the younger son, though incapable of any liberal art or profession, may be pleased in such a way of life as may perhaps enable them to be with the best of their family. Accordingly, we find several citizens that were launched into the world with narrow fortunes, rising by an honest industries to a greater estate than those of their elder brother. It is not improbable, but Will was formally tried at divinity, law or psyche, and that finding his genius did not lie that way, his parents gave him up at length to his own invention. But next paragraph, but certainly, however improper he might have been for studies of a higher nature, he was perfectly well turned for the occupation of trade and commerce. As I think this is a point which cannot be too much inculcated, I shall desire my reader to compare what I have here written with what I have said in another speculation. Okay, see, the spectator imagines that Will might have tried formally at divinity, law and psyche, but when all these failed, his family gave him up and left him to his own choice. The spectator thinks that Will was a quite well qualified for a trade and commerce. So Joseph Steele ends this prose by universalizing the problem of difference between two brothers, that is a younger and the elder brother. His essays are noted for their clarity and elegant style, as well as their cheerful and respectful humor. So it is only because if Wimble is not chosen the job of his elder brother, he might have been good in commerce, as Steele said. So it is a very, very important essay. And then see here, the author and explain about the how the parents are. How the parents, in the last third paragraph, he explained about the Will Wemble, how the family members. See, Will Wemble could not have excelled in business or a trade. The false notion of dignity and family pride stops people like him from using their talent. He is, that is, the spectator to think in general the plight of younger sons in the country. So unfortunately, his parents compelled him to choose a trade which he was not interested. Thus, his life has been ruined. It is not a personal loss, it is a loss of the nation too. Many of our younger talent were going astray like this. Only an amendment in law can do justice to people like Will Wemble. So this is the end. So here, his style had such an impact that even Dr. Johnson could not but praised it. Dr. Johnson praised the way of style writing which was written by Edison. That is, Dr. Johnson said, whosoever wishes to attain an English style must give his days and nights to the study of Edison. When they have started to read Edison's work, automatically they will improve their own style. This is the criticism which was given by Dr. Johnson about style. Okay, if you want any other essays to be explained, you are welcome to put in a comment box so that I can read and I can explain the essay. So first paragraph, see in this how the person, spectator and then Roger were walking together. During that time, the person comes in between and then he speaks, and then he has given the letter and Jack the fish, and then the letter is about what are the things, and then Will Wemble Sir Spectator need to know about Will Wemble. And after knowing that, one day Will Wemble is coming to his house, that is a Sir Roger house, and by the way, what he has taken come, and he has given one box to the old woman, that is the old lady, and the servant. And these are all the important characters. And after meeting in the dinner table, they are speaking about some important things. And then during that adventurous life of Will Wemble, and after speaking, Sir Roger is thinking about why Will Wemble like this. And then going on thinking about Will Wemble and telling Will Wemble qualities and how he is simple and how he is humble and so on so. And thank you for your valuable time to listen this video. If you want to hear some other prose explanation, can you kindly put it in a comment box. And thank you all once again. Thank you.